So today, Matt, we're talking about the Bakken Shale Formation, and you know, this is something you know you follow pretty closely. First off the bat, let's just tell our listeners what the Bakken Shale is, where it's located. So, it underlies parts of Montana, North Dakota, Saskatchewan, and Manitoba. Oil was first discovered there in 1951. But production efforts really struggled for the next 50 years until fracking came on board. And do you want to talk about kind of how the Bakken's evolved over the past decade or so and what fracking has made possible there, when it comes to oil recovery and those sorts of things?
Yeah, so oil companies knew that there was oil there. They just didn't know how to get it out. So as they figured out how to do shale plays, they started out in the Barnett Shale of Texas and they moved it up to the Marcellus. They figured out that combining horizontal drilling with hydraulic fracturing was like the key to unlocking these things. So they tested it out in the Bakken. That was like 2003, 2004. Continental Resources, they were the leaders out there, and they figured it out, and it's just taken off since then. They've been tweaking the process, but it has been just phenomenal how much oil they've been able to pull out of that region, mostly North Dakota. They pulled out some from Montana. Canada's got a little bit, but North Dakota just been on fire.
Yeah, and just to illustrate these numbers, for our listeners. So in 1995, the U.S. Geological Survey estimated that the Bakken contained 151 million barrels of recoverable oil. Recently, in September 2018, Continental Resources, which you mentioned, one of the largest players in the Bakken, which we'll discuss later on the show, estimated that there were 30 to 40 billion barrels of recoverable oil in the Bakken. So you see that's a ridiculous increase in the recoverable oil, which has really just been made possible by this hydraulic fracturing. And I think the stat that I saw, which just blew my mind, is that North Dakota is the number two state in the United States for oil production, which is mind-boggling. Everybody thinks about Alaska and Texas, but over there in North Dakota, these shale oil plays have really opened up. Do you want to talk about what's the Bakken looking like today? What's the production profile and what are the prospects going forward?
Yeah, so because oil prices dipped, that really hurt the Bakken. It had pretty high costs, like $12 million to drill a well. So as oil prices went down, companies just didn't have the money to drill. That caused production to fall off during, 2016, 2017. So after peaking, I think it peaked around 1.2 million barrels in 2015. It dipped below a million for a while. But with oil prices rising and companies were able to cut their costs, they've just really started to ramp up drilling up there. And the latest I saw was 1.3 million barrels is the latest peak. And a lot of that has come because they've figured out better ways to drill wells. They're drilling them faster. They're drilling them more productive. They're using more sand as they're fracturing. So that's just allowed them to produce more oil per well, which has just made it so much more profitable. I saw a stat from Continental Resources back in 2011. It was like less than 20% return on a well. Now it's 175% return on a well. So it's just a huge, huge gain in how much they can make on these wells. So that's what's driving this production. And they think it could reach 2 million barrels a day eventually.
Yeah, which that is, I mean, that's 20% of Saudi Arabia's oil production. That's a large chunk of oil coming from, a relatively, underappreciated oil play up there in North Dakota. We were talking before the show that, as a result of this big spike in oil production in the Bakken, that, we've seen some pipeline capacity become a little strained. Do you want to talk a little bit about that and what risks that may pose for the play, over the next 12 months or so?
Yeah, pipelines have been an issue in the Bakken since the beginning. A couple of years ago, they were trying to build the Bakken pipeline. There's two pipelines by Energy Transfer Partners that would move oil out of the Bakken, but it's very controversial. Made the news. It was delayed for a while. They finally got that online, and that's really helped boost production lately. However, that's basically full. It was a 470,000 barrel a day pipeline. And it's currently over 500,000 barrels a day because they've been able to make some slight changes. However, with it basically full, they're asking shippers if they want to take some more capacity. And if they do, then they're going to make some changes, add some pumping stations to kind of boost that pipeline. And in addition to that, you've got natural gas that they used to flare up there, just burn it off because there's no pipelines. But now they've got the the processing plants and the pipelines to get that out. However, again, that's filling up. So Kinder Morgan, they mentioned that they're looking at some natural gas pipeline possibilities, maybe taking it down the Rockies, maybe going to California. And the third thing that they produce out there is natural gas liquids, NGLs. One Oak, they're in the process of building the Elk Creek pipeline, which will move NGLs down the Rockies. It'll also pick up some from Powder River Basin. So there's a lot of pipelines that they're building. There's a lot of pipelines that need to be built. It's just a huge opportunity, especially for income investors that are looking for growth and income. Pipeline companies that are building the Bakken could be pretty big in the future.
Exactly. I mean, we're seeing all this investment from the pipeline players. Just goes to show that, I mean, over the long term, they're really expecting oil to continue to come out of this region and for production to perhaps continue going forward.